Hello, I'm Kate Humble, and welcome to our farm.
They are the warmest, cuddliest things on a winter morning.
I started like a lot of people do with chickens, and then somebody gave me some geese, and then somebody else gave me some ducks, and then I got slightly drunk at somebody's house having dinner one night, who said, do you want some piglets? And I went, oh yeah, sounds like a lovely idea. And I got piglets, and lo and behold, I'd suddenly become a smallholder. They're all good layers, these ones. And so what we're doing at Humble by Nature is giving people really a taster of that idea of hopefully connecting them back with where food comes from, how it's produced, and showing them that it doesn't need to be something kind of mystical, something just left to farmers or to people who've got a huge amount of land. Any of us can do this. This is the little kind of preparation kitchen here at Humble by Nature, and this is Catherine Marland.
Today it's a small holding course, so we're using some locally made sausages. We're using a lot of eggs because people that have small holdings tend to have a lot of chickens, and then we're using some garden grown rhubarb for the pudding, a rhubarb crumble cake.
The lovely thing about our kind of common approach to food is trying to use things that are as local as possible and just make food very much part of the day here. There is something really wonderful about keeping animals, even if it's just chickens. Something about the routine of getting up, feeding, checking your animals, it kind of connects you to the natural world.
There's a lot of interest in goat meat now, isn't there? And there's a huge demand sort of ethnically. You know, Birmingham places is a big market for it.
To be able to know that the eggs that I eat have been laid by the chickens that I feed and I look after, and I know they're healthy, I know they're happy, I know they've got a whole quarter of an acre to run around in, makes me feel really good, and the eggs do taste better. The problem of leaving a tub in for a long time is that you might have something, you know, lamb in January, but if you've left them in, you could have something still lambing in April, by which time you're ready to hang yourself, you're so exhausted. When I moved into keeping bigger animals, so pigs and sheep, you know, to be able to take somebody that you're going to supper with a bag of sausages that, again, you know, they've come from an animal that you've bred, and you know it's been impeccably looked after because you've done it, there's something really satisfying about that.
When they are ready to shear, the mane of the wool rises away from the skin slightly, so you only end up with half the fibres or less actually connecting the fleece to the sheep.
I hope that more and more people will come down to this little corner of Monmouthshire. I think when you tell people it's Wales, they think, oh, crikey, that's going to take 15 hours then, isn't it? Very, very close to the motorway, very close to Bristol, very accessible here. But we hope that people will just come and even if they live in the middle of a city and think, oh, well, I'd love to have a day here, I'm never going to do it, go, well, that's fine, come and have a day, come and see what's possible. You know, you might live in the middle of London like I did, but have an allotment, and an allotment society could get together and go, well, we could use that one allotment to keep a few chickens and have a hive of bees, you know, and then suddenly you're producing your own food. So I'm banging on, but I'm a bit evangelical about this, and I'd love everybody else to get the buzz out of it that I do.